it all started, 33 came on Sunday, and then I knew they were going to go because I got the eggs about 200 on one Saturday, 200 on a Sunday, and that was 4 weeks ago. So it takes them about, you know, it takes them 2 weeks to get into the chrysalis, maybe another week to become a butterfly, so 3 to 4 weeks. It's a big day. This one has fallen, so we're going to try to get her back up there so that she can open her wings. They need to hang vertical so that they can let their wings inflate. There she is. She'll be fine. Put him out here in solitary. This girl needs to get up here and hang. I'm going to put her somewhere where she can hang and let her wings inflate. There we go. Come on. So this is my overspill from the boxes. What you really have to do is space them about 3 inches apart and one in the middle down below so that they don't drip their fluids onto the next butterfly below. It can cause them to not open up. It can cause their wings to develop deformed. I try to space them as far apart as I can and still have room for everybody. There's my food bag. I have to wash them and dry them. These were eggs that I harvested yesterday, except for one. I got this one on the way home from work today. So that is a monarch butterfly egg.
Very smart.
And a macro of this is really cool. They're about 0.9 millimeters by 1.2 millimeters in height. It's a little oval, but it's got all of these little ribs all the way up it, so make it makes a pretty nice strong structure to withstand, you know, getting beat up on by leaves and stuff. And then when they've hatched, you got that little guy.
Little.
And then about 2 days later, after he's eaten his fill, you get this guy. And then the madness begins. Then they start eating and molting so many times that it's hard to keep up with them. So it's about a 3 hour job every day, about a 2 hours at night just cleaning them. You got to keep the whole container needs to stay dry. These have just molted, so they've left their skin behind, and they'll turn around and eat that. That's their always a good protein source for them. He's eating his right now. And once they get too big, they go in the big boy containers. And so these guys are monsters. They eat and poop a lot. These guys will eat, these three will eat 6 leaves a day. They'll attach the back legs that have crochets on them. And they'll lose all muscle control. They'll hang in the J for a day or so. And then they shed their skin. One last molt. This guy has you guys just missed that one. He's still forming his shape, so he's really soft right now. If he dropped, it would be over for him. So he's still moving to make sure that he's buttoned really good to the top there so that he doesn't fall. And here's one changing. Right now. He's shedding his skin right down, right now. He's getting ready to dump it. So these I'll let harden for a couple days, and then they become hardened, jade like those other ones, and then I can handle them. I'll take the pen, I'll get all the silk around it, and I'll pull them off and stick them in a temporary shoebox I keep up in my grow room. And when there's room in the boxes, then I bring them down and I pen them.